Travis and his family are on a whale watch off the coast of Washington when disaster strikes in overboard. The boat capsizes, throwing everyone into the ice-cold, chaotic waves. Separated from their families and struggling to stay afloat, Travis and Marina must use all of their grit and knowledge to survive. This Edge of Your Seat story has real cold water survival tips that could help you to survive a disaster.
In The Double Cross and Other Skills I Learned as a Super Spy, everyone in 12-year-old Hale's family is a spy, going way back. They've all worked for Sub Rosa Society, an elite organization that's so top secret that new agents aren't recruited. They're born. His parents may be the ultimate spy team, but he isn't your typical stealthy spy. He is, as his mother puts it, big bone. Still, he's convinced he will someday be a great field agent. After all, it's his legacy.
Zoe discovers a photo of a glowing animal and learns an amazing secret in dragons and marshmallows. Her mom helps injured magical animals when they come to their backyard barn for help. When a sick baby dragon appears, it's up to Zoe and her cat Sassafras to figure out what's wrong. Will they be able to help little Marshmallow before it's too late? If you like this story, there's a whole series of Zoe and Sassafras books.
Winnie's last day of fourth grade ended with a pretty life-changing surprise in The Great Treehouse War. That was the day Winnie's parents got divorced and decided that Winnie would live 3 days a week with each of them and spend Wednesdays by herself in a treehouse between their houses to divide her time evenly. It was a day Winnie's seed of frustration with her parents was planted, a seed that grew until it felt like it was as big as the tree itself. Winnie and her friends declared war on the grown-ups, and soon things get even crazier. Sometimes the adults need to listen to the kids.
If you like Jurassic Park type of adventures, check out The Ark Plan. 5 years ago, Skye's father vanished from the North compound. Now, she has found a clue that not only suggests his disappearance is part of an even bigger mystery, but also points directly to the surface. To find her dad and possibly even save the world, Skye and her best friend have to break out of the underground home and go topside to a land ruled by dinosaurs. This is a mind-blowing adventure and the first book in the series.
11-year-old P.T. may be the greatest storyteller alive in the book, Home Sweet Motel. But he knows one thing for a fact. The Wonderland Motel is the best place a kid could ever live. There's only one thing the Wonderland doesn't have, though. Customers. And if the Wonderland doesn't get them soon, P.T. and his friend Gloria may have to say goodbye to their beloved motel forever. They need to think big. They need an outrageous plan. With Gloria's smarts and P.T.'s world-famous stories, there's got to be a way to save the Wonderland.
In the book Lemons, Lemony Liberty Wits, Mama always told her, when life gets you lemons, make lemonade. But Lynn can't possibly make lemonade out of her new life in Willow Creek, California, the big fig capital of the world, where she's forced to live with a grandfather she's never met. She meets Tobin Skye, a Bigfoot detective who invites her to be his assistant for the summer. Together, Lem and Tobin try to get a picture of the mysterious beast and end up fighting more than they ever could have imagined.
Lights, Camera, Cook is a fun series for fans of MasterChef Junior and Kids Cook-Off. In book one, four talented tween chefs step into the spotlight to prove that they have what it takes to become the next best junior chef. Who will have the grits to get through week one of competition? As a bonus, this book includes real cooking techniques for you to try.
11-year-old Charlie Reese has been making the same secret wish every day since fourth grade. She even has a list of all the ways there are to make the wish. But when she is sent to the Blue Ridge Mountains of North Carolina to live with family she barely knows, it seems unlikely that her wish will ever come true. That is, until she meets Wishbone, a skinny stray dog who captures her heart, and Howard, a neighbor boy who is surprising in lots of ways. Suddenly, Charlie is in danger of discovering that what she thought she wanted may not be what she needs at all.
In the book I Love You, Michael Collins, it's 1969 and one of the most exciting moments in U.S. history, men landing on the moon. Mamie's class is given an assignment to write letters to astronauts. Only Mamie writes to Michael Collins, the astronaut who doesn't actually get to walk on the moon because he must stay with the space shuttle. Mamie keeps writing to Michael Collins, telling him about her family. One by one, they leave the house thinking that someone else is taking care of her. And as the day of the launch nears, Mamie can't help but wonder, does no one stay with the ship anymore?
In the book, Spirit Week Showdown, Magnificent Maya Tibbs is super excited about the best week of the whole school year, Spirit Week! She and her best friend Naomi even made a pinky promise to be Spirit Week partners so they can win the big prize. Special VIP tickets to the Fall Festival! But when the partner picking goes horribly wrong, Maya gets paired with mean Connie Tate, the biggest bully in school, and she can't get out of it. Now Naomi is furious at Maya for breaking a promise, even though Maya couldn't help it, and everyone at school is calling Maya names. Can Maya work with Mean Connie to win the VIP tickets and get her best friend back?
Harvard Hotel, a true home, is about Mona the Mouse. She stumbles across the wondrous world of Harvard Hotel in the middle of a storm. She desperately hopes to let her stay. As it turns out, Mona is exactly the maid they need at the grandest hotel in Fernwood Forest, where animals come from far and wide for safety, luxury, and comfort. But the Harwood Hotel is not all acorn souffle and soft beds. As danger approaches, Mona finds that this hotel is more than a warm place to spend the night. It might also be a home if you like a true home. It's the first book in a series.
An Ugly Cat and Pablo. Ugly Cat is dying for a paleta, or ice pop. His mouse friend Pablo is determined to help him get one by scaring a little girl who is enjoying a coconut pop in the park. But things go horribly wrong when, instead of being scared, the little girl picks up Pablo and declares that he would make a great snack for her pet snake. In all of the commotion and confusion, Ugly Cat wonders if he might have accidentally swallowed Pablo himself. This is the first book in a super silly series.
Podkin 1 Year takes place in a fantasy world of three human-like rabbits. Three young siblings are on the run from the villain tribe. Podkin, once meant to be the leader, has always been spoiled, but now he must act bravely as they run for their lives. During their dangerous adventure, the three meet friends while searching for shelter. And at last, they are ready to fight back and save the land from evil.
For 10-year-old Cadence Jolly, birthdays are a constant reminder of all that's changed since her mother left town with dreams of being a star and the sweetest sound. Cadence inherited that musical soul, but other than that, she couldn't be more different. She's shy as can be. She did make a promise last year that she would try and break out of her shell, just a little, and she prayed that she'd get the courage to do it. When a secret recording of her singing gets out and catches the attention of her whole church, she needs to decide what's better, lying to everyone by pretending it belongs to someone else, or finally stepping into the spotlight.